Guys, should we watch TV?
Yeah!
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Selling Swithuns. Today we are selling this luxurious two-story apartment. Come and take a look.
Here you can see a luxury entranceway of our grand staircase.
As you can see, there's a luxury open plan living space.
Extravagant floor to ceiling windows.
We have our luxurious basement where you can keep all of your guests. Welcome to the master bedroom.
This is the epitome of indoor outdoor living.
It even comes with a luxurious walk-in wardrobe.
Water features.
Thank you for visiting this luxurious apartment with us. Now on to our colleagues that are going to explore more apartments in this.
We wanted to show you one of our most luxurious bedrooms so you can get a real feel of what this luxury apartment is really like.
This retails for $1 million a month, which you might think is a little bit on the cheap side, but we promise it comes with everything you need. Let's take a look.
The interior design of this place really wanted to enhance the industrial feel of it, so this is where the pipes come in.
It comes with a luxury king-size bed, which is perfect for any partners you plan to take home.
This lovely chandelier really just explains why this place is so expensive.
The textured walls were a deliberate choice by our designer, and are designed to reflect the hardships of staying in jail. We really hope you consider buying this luxurious $1 million per month property.
Thank you so much for watching Selling Swithuns. We hope to see you next time.
Welcome to the next gorgeous house on Selling Swithuns. Follow me.
This property has the perfect outdoor and indoor feature. Amazing for the warm, sunny environment.
Here is our beautiful property's spacious and well-lit kitchen,
with a beautiful view of our outdoor seating area.
And to conclude on this gorgeous property visit, here is its spacious storage facilities.
Now for a quick ad break, but up next is You've Been Framed.
Welcome to You Have Been Shamed. Watch out tonight for a man on a mission, collisions, and some bad decisions. For your chance to win 250 e-praise points, submit a video to me, Mr. Hanson, so I can rate your epic fails. Now, introducing a special section of tonight's show, Celebrity Lookalikes. That's all for today. See you next time.
Good morning and welcome to Swith News. I'm your host, Professor Alexandra Chandler, PhD in Green, and I'm joined here today by
Rasta Ambassador for Hampshire,
Amelia Tonnell.
Today in news, Rev Wellington has finally been put to justice after years of selling Jelly Baby January edibles to younger years.
The news only came to light as one of the middle fives had 50 grams stolen from her own house, at which point she reported it to the authorities, without knowing that this would result in her expulsion.
I'm here with one of the middle five in question. How did you get found out?
Well, I didn't think they would know that Ganja Ganja was code for...
In other news, the patriarchy process that set base in the Mojo Dojo Casa House last spring are stronger than ever.
We are Kenuff! We are Kenuff! We...
Thank you, Rastandla. I'm live in the Mojo Dojo Casa House with the protesters. So, what's your demand?
It's not so much demands, more just respect. Every time I don't play a video in a lesson, I just get heckled.
And if you don't agree with us, things are going to get ugly.
Yeah.
These protests, as you can see, are becoming increasingly hostile. Just this morning, Nicholas Fyfe, aka the Egg of Emsworth, was detained for not smiling at Miss Gandhi on the way to assembly.
Not only do they sell dashing uniform, we're also told they sell the all important tracksuits that they wear over the skirts.
What do you make of the tracksuits?
It's no from me.
It comes to things from the tuck shop today, I suppose.
We hope you enjoyed the tuck shop documentary. After the ad break, it's Swith Island.
You can be the most responsible driver, but danger is always lurking. And even though you were paying attention, everybody makes mistakes. So this is your reminder to
be conscious, stay far.
Welcome to Swith Island, the only place to be sporty, single, and ready to mingle this term. Tonight on Swith Island, thrills, spills, and netball drills.
Oh my god, there's new people!
Hot new bombshells enter the villa.
Hi, I'm Mr. Riley. I describe myself in three words: buff, buff, and buffer. In my spare time, I hit the gym, I go running and hit the gym some more. If you want to know, I bench 200 kg. And my favourite feature is my hair.
Hi, I'm Miss Riley. I'm 21 and I'm from Berkhamsted. My friends would describe me as the three Fs: fast, fit, and frisky. My best feature is my smile, and it's definitely going to be an Asher summer.
While the Riley power couple enter the villa, a relationship hits the rocks.
Hi, girls. Can I call you for a chat real quick?
Yeah, sure.
I just wanted to see where your head is at, because I've been cracking on with the first team and I don't want to...
Bombastic side eye.
I feel like I'm stepping on your toes.
I mean, like, we've been coupled up since the beginning and the first team's 100% my time on paper, but I mean, if you're willing to go for it, then I guess we got to see what happens.
I mean, I think that went pretty well, considering what Curls had to say, so I guess I'm just going to have to shoot my shot and see what happens.
Not gonna lie, I'm feeling pretty mugged off and I don't like feeling like a mug. But you know what? Early days, so maybe I'll just crack on with the seconds and see what happens.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Better not to have all my eggs in one basket.
Stay tuned for next week to see if the drama continues.
Up next after the break, it's Universally Challenged.
If you can make toast, you can ride a hobby horse. If you can ride a hobby horse, you can survive being a lower four. If you can survive being a lower four, you can deal jelly babies with Rev. If you can deal jelly babies with Rev, you can be a nun. I was born in Hampshire, but I was made at St. Swithun's.
University Challenge.
Welcome to Universally Challenged. I'm Amelia.
And I'm Charles.
And we are your hosts.
In order to win the grand prize today, they're going to have to answer all 8 questions correctly. Ready?
Ready.
Okay, Alice, you're up first. What is Miss Gandhi's most used phrase?
I think it has to be fail once, fail better.
You are correct.
4, here's a stinky one. Which toilets were voted worst in school?
Harvey Hall has to be the bottom.
Correct! Which boys' school was voted number one fittest boys?
None of them.
Again, correct!
Next up is Ishal. Which year group has the most beef?
Easy, upper 5.
What is the most worn clothing item in sixth form?
The skinny scarves.
Now, it's Sienna's questions. What is the most booming school business? Is it A, skirt hemming, shout out to Tailored by Day, B, wink cups, bridge shop runners, or the Backfield Blend Society?
Skirt hemming?
That is good. And what is the most common reason for getting a detention?
You're not smiling.
That is correct! Now it's time for AJ Tracy, aka Annabelle Josie.
Can't wait to go for the final prize.
Question number 1. What topic gets brought up most in school forum?
It's got to be food complaints.
That is correct! Next question, Annabelle. Who is the best hymn singer?
Mr. Blassie?
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
And that concludes this year's episode of Universally Challenged.
See you next year.
Keep on being
Caritas,
Humilitas,
and Sinceritas. Bye-bye.
A quick ad break before Ghostbusters.
Are you joining senior school soon and have no clue what to expect?
We've got you covered.
With our latest and state-of-the-art technology, SwithGuide has all the information you need. We have everything from the length of your skirt to the size of your backpack and blazer, and even a step-by-step tutorial for sending a whole school email.
Lower 4 is better with SwithGuide.
Further fees may apply. We take no responsibility for any consequences or bullying that takes place after following this guide.
Tonight on Ghostbusters,
we investigate the ongoing search of Timothy Dixon.
Today, I'm here speaking with... Take 2. Today, I'm here speaking with... Right. And tell us what you saw.
I swear he's real. He was talking to me about my new cast.
So you are claiming that you saw the ghost of Tim Dixon?
I didn't just see him.
He spoke to me.
I'm here talking with ghost expert
Dr. Vinyl Dixon,
who claims he's an expert at hunting ghosts.
Sorry, what are you doing?
I'm just checking you're not a ghost. Right.
I'm very much.
Oh, hello.
Okay, okay. Oh, yeah.
It seems we have an update from our ghost expert. Let's see what he's found out.
I am searching with the thing for any signs of
Jimmy.
Follow me.
If you have any questions, please do come back to me.
Yeah, I've got 5 people missing from my lesson.
Send out the hunters.
You look so dumb right now.
Right, I'm on it.
Miss Hansen. Meanwhile.
The man them too inconsiderate, 5-star hotel smoking cigarette, mixing codeine up with a Finnegan. She got thick but she wanna get thin again, drinking.
Hi Miss, whatever time P lessons are, we're in the common room. This is our chosen spot.
I think we need to take a digital approach.
Oh, hi, Tegan.
Hey.
Next up, live from Harvey Hall, it's Swithun's Come Dancing!